بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، ثم الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين حبيب إله العالمين بالقاسم المصطفى محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. Dear respected viewers, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Once again we have this opportunity to be discussing the holy verses of the Quran and the narrations of Ahl Bayt عليهم السلام, and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us to be able to bring these lessons that has been driven from the holy verses of Quran and the narrations of Ahl Bayt alayhi wasalam into our lives, inshallah. We are discussing the last verse of Surah Al-Hamd, صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. O Allah, guide me to the right path. Which path? The path of those whom you have blessed, such as have not incurred your wrath, nor are astray. Within the past episode, previous episode, we discuss about why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us examples and role models rather than saying, okay, follow sarati. Why Allah didn't mention follow saratullah. Rather, he said sarata alladhina an'amta alayhim, the path of those people who you have blessed. We mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings us role model, because when we read these stories of the people who have already been on the right path, we will know what to do and what to implement, and basically taking baby steps toward gaining Allah's satisfaction and getting closer to Him, inshallah. And we brought examples of the lives of the holy prophets. So, صراط الذين أنعمت, who are those people that you have blessed? What is this blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with and has blessed the people that He said, you have to follow the path of those who I have blessed. What is this blessing? Number one, we look at the holy verses of the Quran, where Allah says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, ألم تروا أن الله سخر لكم ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وأسبغ عليكم نعمه ظاهرة وباطنة. Chapter 31, verse 20. Do you not see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has disposed for you whatever there is in the heavens and whatever there is in the earth, and has showered upon you His blessing, the outward and inward? Two ni'mah, two blessings, group of blessings, one internal, inward, and one outward. Many discussions and many lectures can be given about the ni'am and the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the outward also and the inward. And as Allah has said within the Holy Quran, if we want to start counting the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has showered us with, we won't be able to finish counting. It's endless. It's infinite, the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has showered us with. But unfortunately, shaitan comes and make us think about and focus only on the things that we don't have, on the blessings that we don't have, which can't be counted. There are a handful. Let's say go 100. Let's go even higher, 1,000 blessings that we don't have. But if we compare them to the amount of blessings which are eternal, which are infinite, the amount of blessings that Allah has showered us with, we should be always thankful for those blessings and not focus on those ni'am and blessings that we don't have, which there is benefit. If Allah has not bestowed us so much with wealth, number one, He might be testing us. Number two, He knows us, that if He gives us that amount of money, we might commit sin. We have within the narrations that somebody is poor. The reason why he's poor, because within his poverty, he is hopeful and he is believer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if he is giving wealth, he might commit sin. And the rich is rich because Allah knows if he goes poor, he will commit sin by being unthankful and ungrateful. And there are many, many reasons why we are who we are and why we have these blessings that we have. So we have internal and external blessings. Amongst them, the internal blessings is that Allah has guided us to the right path. He has given us nature, fitrah, which our fitrah takes us to the right path. And the external and our intellect, internal, and the external are the prophets and the imams, which these two sync with one another, our intellect and our nature, plus the outside, our prophets and the imams, which they sync, give hand in hand together to guide us to the right path. So everywhere we cast our eyes, we see the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The inward blessings, again, faith in Allah, prophethood, believing in the imams of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. This is a blessing that we have to be really, really thankful. We have to really appreciate that amongst all of these religions, thousands of religions, we are the believers of Muhammad and Ali Muhammad salawatullah alayhim ajma'een. That we are holding, inshallah, firmly to the path of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam, which this is the only path that will lead us to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we can gain His satisfaction. As we talked about it within a previous episode, that is only one sarat, ihdin as-sarat. Guide me to the right path, one path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is the path of Muhammad and al-Muhammad. And it's obvious that ni'mah, we're talking here, and that Allah has bestowed, is not about the worldly matters. That we're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to the right path, to the path that you have bestowed your mercy, and that mercy we're thinking of those people who have wealth and who have luxury life. No, that's not the blessings that we are discussing. Even that is a blessing, but that is not what we are thinking. Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam have directed our attention, inshallah, to a hadith that we will read. So we're not thinking about, oh Allah, the ones that have fancier car are definitely receiving your mercy, and the one who don't have any means of, for example, transportation, they don't have your mercy. Not at all. A lot of people that they don't have, they have bare minimum to survive, they might be more happy and more satisfied and more content than those who have millions and millions and millions of dollars. We do see them, they commit suicide, and when they've been interviewed, some of them, they are not happy, they are not satisfied. They might have a smile on their face when they are in front of cameras and we see them that they have a luxury life, but internally, they are not satisfied. Internally, they are not happy. Internally, they are not happy with their lives. The one who are bigger house, we're not asking about those people. We are not asking the path of those who have been drowned in the wealth and don't see anything else then piling and increasing their wealth. Actually, we are looking for the inner beauty than outer beauty. So what are the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about? So we're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to the right path, the path of those people who has blessed. What is this blessing? An Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam, a beautiful narration where Imam says, في قول الله عز وجل, Imam is explaining to us what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means. Sirat al-ladhina an'amta alayhim, the path of those people who you have bestowed and you have showered your blessing upon them. Ayqulu ihdina sirat al-ladhina an'amta alayhim bit-tawfiq li-dinik wa ta'atik. Sirat al-ladhina an'amta means you have an'amta, you have blessed them with what? With giving them tawfiq. Tawfiq means blessing, means that we have the opportunity. For example, when we get tawfiq, one kind of tawfiq is when you have good kids. That's tawfiq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's a blessing. When you have a good spouse, that's a blessing. When you have a good health, that's a blessing. When you get the opportunity to come and visit the shrines of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam within the holy land of Karbala and Kadhameen and Samarra and Najaf al-Ashraf, that's a blessing. But tawfiq what? To have the blessing, what is this blessing? لدينك. Those who have your religion, those who are applying your faith, those who are religious people. Number one, وطاعتك. Number two. Oh Allah, we are asking you every day, minimum 10 times, guide us to the path of the people who are following your religion, who are true, truthful in their faith, and they are showing obedience to you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهُمُ الَّذِينَ قَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. Who are these people who are following your religion, who are abide by the rules and by the sharia that you have brought for them, and they are obedient, they are good servants of yours, and they show obedience to you, they are الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. Four groups of people are on the right path, that we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to this right path, which He has bestowed His blessing, and that blessing is that they are showing obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they are religious, following the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, following the sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are four people. We read them, the same group of people. We read them in chapter 4, verse 69. وَمَنْ يُطِعَ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا. Beautifully, we can put all the verses of the Holy Quran and the narrations of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam together for us to find the right path. There is no question, there is no doubt left if we hold on, as we have mentioned it numerous times, if we hold on to the holy book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the verses of the Holy Quran and the narrations of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam, where Rasulullah said, I'm leaving you these two valuable things. If we hold on to both of them together, we will not go astray. Who are those people? Whoever obeys Allah and the Apostle, they are with those whom Allah have blessed. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. Who are those people? Allah says, chapter 4, verse 69, those whom Allah has blessed, including the prophets and the truthful and the witnesses and the righteous, and excellent companions are they. So there are four groups of people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned that I, Allah, have bestowed my mercy upon them. And we are asking Allah to place us on the path that He has placed these four people been on this path. We're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let's go one after one within these four categories and to see what is explanation, what is the meaning. Because we want, again, we want to be in the right path. Right path, who are on this? Have people been on this right path? Yes. And that's the beauty of it. That we have this assurance, we have this confidence that it's not something acrimonious, something very vague, something very confusing. No, it's something vivid and clear path. So already people been on this path and they have reached salvation and they have reached highest level that they can reach. So we are not alone. It's not something new. It's not something that nobody has gone. That is something we don't know if it's going to get us to the right ending or it will have a bad and dead end. No, it's a path of those people. There are four groups of people that have been on this right path and they have walked on this path. So they've been already there. And Allah has given us the GPS. If you want to be on the right path, every day 10 times you say, I want to be on the right path. Okay, take this GPS. This GPS, other people have used it. Who are those people? From prophets, nabiyin, Siddiqeen, the truthful, shuhada, the witnesses, and salihin. So let's go and examine each one of these four groups. Number one, the prophets. Definitely, obvious, nabiyin. No discussion, no talk about it because we know them. According to our narrations, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent 124,000 prophets, starting with Prophet Adam, ala nabina wa alayhi salam, all the way to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. And the life that they lived, and the examples that we brought in the previous episode, what they went through, and how much they were firm in their belief, no matter, despite what they went through, despite the difficulties, despite the challenges, but they were firm believers. So, prophets. And then, was-siddiqeen, the truthful. Let us pause here. Who are siddiqeen? We have sadiq and we have siddiqeen. Sadiq is a person who is truthful in his talk. He will not lie. Whatever he says, he is truthful in his statement that he makes. This person is called Sadiq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in here is talking about Saddiqeen, the truthful. Saddiqeen are those people who their action and what they say matches. Whatever they say matches their heart and what they believe. And whatever they believe matches what they say. Both of them matches. So let us think about it. Let us pause here. how many of us, let me examine myself. I, Mustafa, how much truthful I am into what I believe and my action. Because a lot of things I might do in the public that I don't believe truly, genuinely, but I do it since basically, again, I bring my own example, I'm a religious scholar, people are looking at me, well, I have to be a good role model. I don't believe it that much, but due to the respect that I want from the people, due to the position that I have within the community, I'll do what I do. So let me examine myself. How much of this action of mine that is present and people can see sinks and matches what I believe inside? Is it 100% together? 100% what I believe matches 100% of my action? Or no, what I do, it looks very nice and 100% good and everybody, mashallah, very good, nice, they clap for me and appreciate me and thank to me. But in my heart, I believe 10%, 20%, 30%, 40%. There's more to this. And what do we mean more? Inshallah, we will leave it for the next episode, inshallah. We will conclude this episode, as we have done it in every episode, and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Thursday night that we are recording these lectures for you. And within the vicinity and the shrines of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, asking by the blessing of Imam Hussein and Abu al-Fadl Abbas, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to hasten the reappearance of our beloved Imam Mahdi ajalallahu ta'ala faraju sharif. Let us read together, raise your hand and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, beg sincerely and genuinely for Allah to hasten his reappearance. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allahumma kun li wadiyyika al-hujjat ibn al-Hasan. Salawatuka alayhi wa ala abaih. Fi hadhihi as-sa'ati wa fi kulli sa'ah. Waliyan wa hafiza wa qa'idan wa nasira wa dalilan wa ayna. Hatta tuskinahu ardaka taw'a wa tumatta'ahu fiha tawila. Bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin.